Slate exclusive.
Another hurdle crossed for the tax cut deal. The bill hits the 60-vote level in the Senate. That's enough votes for the plan to advance toward a final vote and pass. President Obama says, in effect, to get the big job done on stimulating the economy and extending jobless benefits, there had to be some concessions.
He said that to our own Kevin Cooney, who sat down with the president a short time ago at the White House. And Kevin joins us live from there. Kevin?
Todd and Cynthia, good evening from the White House. You know, topic number one here was the tax deal. And the president today told me that the hope and change idea is alive and well. But he says Americans are going to have to make some pretty tough choices.
The truth is, my attitude towards these high income tax cuts remains exactly the same. I don't think they're necessary. I don't think they help the economy. I don't think we can afford them.
Why then is the president supporting the extension of the Bush tax cuts? He says Republicans would simply let the middle class tax cuts lapse as well.
The worst thing we could do for the economy right now would be to see middle class families all across America suddenly see their taxes go up by $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 per family.
The president campaigned against tax cuts extensively in Iowa during a campaign that professed hope and change.
Well, look, we just went through the two toughest years that we've had since the Great Depression economically. So it's not surprising that people have been feeling a little deflated. We are moving in a good direction. And I'm confident over the next 2 years we're going to continue to move in a good direction. And I think that people are going to start feeling that we've weathered the storm, but they're also going to understand we've got to make some tough choices.
As for what those tough choices are, we'll talk to the president about that coming up at 6. And what happens when the extension of the Bush tax cuts expires in 2 years, right about the same time that a lot of congressmen and the president himself are campaigning for re-election. We'll have that for you coming up tonight at 6 and 10.
All right, we'll watch for that, Kevin. In the meantime, tell us what it was like visiting the White House today.
Well, I'll tell you what, there's no place in the world, I don't think, quite like the White House at Christmas time. The president, we talked to him a little bit about it, and he said, you know, there's probably 50 Christmas trees all over the White House, and what a great time it is, not only that there's kind of a perpetual party going on, if it's not for one group of volunteers or one other aspect of the White House staff, it's another sort of party going on, maybe for some school children or something like that. We'll hear from that, hear from the president about that, but suffice to say that this is a beautiful time to be in a beautiful city.
All right, Kevin, thanks a lot. We'll see you here at 6.